Thank you so much for staying with us. You can be part of the conversation. Hashtag politics today at CTV Politics or at Sheung Okin, or send an email to Ross Politics Today at channelstv.com. And at some point, you will find some of your comments scrolling right there on your screen. Well, much of the conversation with Chief Oyegun, the national chairman of the APC, was on the economy. But let's get back into that other part where we started by asking him on the issues about the crack in the APC. Going into other issues of your party. Your party seems to be very divided right now. Are you bothered?
We have issues. I am bothered. First, let me take a theoretical lesson. We are a progressive party. We are left of center party. And progressive parties tend to be very voluble in expressing their ideas, their principles, their desires, and the rest of that. You can find some of, take some of these prominent lawyers. You find them taking up issues with us. We know they are with us in spirit. We know they espouse our principles and the rest of it. But they still take issues. That's the way these things are. And given the way we came about, it's only to be expected that there will be this grating period. What is happening now is everybody is gradually finding its level within the party and beginning to settle down. What happens tomorrow, we cannot tell. But given our history, that is only natural. Given our nature, that is only natural. Given the fact that we are left of center party, we tend to be very argumentative. We tend to discuss. We tend to disagree. But finally, we get...
Do you still have the grip on your party?
Very much.
Really?
Very much.
I mean, because, I mean, some of the things that we have seen recently, impeachment threats, for that to come,
no,
that is a political collapse in your party.
That is a non-issue. It really was a fringe kind of expression. That wasn't a serious issue. Nobody has submitted any motion for any impeachment. That was a fringe issue, but it was good to kill it as soon as.
But you're not bothered that those kind of talks can come up anyways?
It is not feasible, it is not possible, it is absolutely nonsensical, and we have too many challenges for anybody to come up with that kind of thing and think he will get away with it. That is not all.
Are you going to punish anybody that is linked to all of this kind of situation?
Because there has been nobody who has gone to say he wants to impeach our president. It will not happen.
The situation in the National Assembly, a lot of people have said, your party has not handled it very well. About a year after that leadership crisis and the election, there's still a lot of ripples on that issue that is generating a lot of division in your party.
Yeah, I don't know whether you can eat your cake and have it. A minute ago, you said fight against corruption, this and that, seems to be discriminatory. These are APC people, basically. And what is happening is that we are refusing to interfere in the judicial process.
What would you say for some people who say that the president is simply intolerant to opposition views?
No. The president does not, I can give you that assurance, does not interfere in these processes. He allows, and that's his instruction, normal processes. Anything you find, deal with it. If it's going to the court, let it go to the court. Let nobody interfere with the processes in the court. So it has nothing to do with intolerance. And get one thing clear. For us to change this nation, for us to have a chance of making a permanent impression and changing the trajectory of this nation, you need somebody who is firm, who seems, unfortunately to those who don't want change, who seems to be hard. And we need such a person. And we are lucky to have a man like that.
It's taking a long time, Chief Oyegun, for a ruling party to get his act together.
Well, the important thing that you want to be permanent, take time. And that is what it is.
You're almost spending 2 years in government.
It requires
2 years or 4 years in government.
It requires the authorization of a convention. And that we are doing. We drafted the revised Board of Elders or whatever we the exact name is. It's already, everything is ready. We are waiting for the convention.
When is you likely to hold a convention?
Very soon.
How soon is that, sir?
The constitution requires that we hold it once every 2 years, and it's about time. In another couple of months, 2-3 months.
Okay, let's go into some issues that bother the minds of so many of the leaders and members of your party. There are several appointments that are supposed to be made. Why has the president not made those appointments?
Well, they are almost ready. I'll tell you why. Because of the economic situation. The nominations were almost concluded. We then decided to take on the Oransai report, do all the measures that he recommended, those aspects that were accepted by this administration. And that meant a total review of the nominations that had been made. That is almost completed now, so it will be out.
Let me quickly take you on some of the leaders in your party. For example, there are issues about a seeming division or rancor between some leaders of the party. For example, the Senate President and a leader of your party, Shuaju Ahmed Tinubu. Things are not going right. What effort are you making?
We are not officially aware about their personal relationships. I don't know how it has manifested itself in any way to us, no.
But I mean, you should get these undercurrents going on, and perhaps how you can wade in.
Well, we deal with undercurrents also as undercurrents. We're dealing with them since they have not manifested into the public domain.
It has manifested to the extent that senior members of your party fight themselves in the Congress, in the Parliament.
They use strong words once in a while. That is parliamentary. It happens in every parliament, in every assembly. Whether it's the US, whether it's Britain or the other, it happens all the time.
Within your party, if two strong senators mm-hmm. for that matter, use abusive words against themselves, Have you considered calling them to resolve this crisis, which is generating a lot of rancor in the ranks of these people?
It was very, very unfortunate, but it's not unusual in assemblies of this nature worldwide. It isn't.